Hi everyone, and welcome back to part 10 in this How to Draw a Tabby Cat coloured pencil tutorial. I hope that you've been enjoying the tutorial so far, and let's just get started with the next part. Everything that you need to know is listed down below, including all of the other parts if you've not seen them yet, and let's just begin. I can't seem to get the lighting perfect in these videos, so I hope you don't mind, but I have put another light up again, and hopefully the shadow underneath my hand isn't too bad and it's nice and bright and clear for you. So we'll try it. It's all trial and error. I'm still learning how to do this. So I'm gonna start on this little bit here and we're gonna like work our way up and join it all together. So I'm gonna use my little eraser, just erase some of these lines, and just on this little section before it meets the paw, I'm just going to add some ivory, making sure to go around this little whisker here. Like that. Just leave it at that for now, and I'm going to use some nougat just to start adding in some first strokes. Just going to draw around that whisker and this one. I hope this lighting's better for you. It's not until like I look at the footage afterwards and see what the lighting's like that I realise I probably need to change it a little bit. Just sort of like leaving a few hairs that'll come off the paw. So like drawing round them a little bit. You can see on the picture there's some like lighter little bits of fur sticking out from the paw, so just don't want to forget about those. Right, I'm going to use a bit of dark sepia now. Just going to add a little bit. Just going to draw under that whisker. I'm just going to add some more just colouring under that whisker so that it tapers towards the end. I'm gonna add some to this section as well. Just drawing around the top up whisker. Gonna draw around the bottom of this one. And then finish adding some strokes that go in sort of like this direction. Is actually a bit where this marking goes a bit further down, so I'm just I'll add a little bit here. I'll do. Sometimes you just miss things. It's not until you have a little look at it again afterwards that you're like, oh yeah, how did I miss that? Darken this little bit up slightly. And this bit definitely needs darkening. Gonna bring that whisker down a little bit, and now I'm gonna use ivory. Dab those pencil lines a little bit. Limp from last time when I smudged it, and just bring that down a little bit. And I'm going to use nougat to start mapping in some strokes again. Right, this is where it gets slightly confusing. So this whisker comes down a little bit and that one kind of ends there, so carry on mapping the fur between these sections. little mark in here. So I'm just going to add that in faintly with the nougat first. And I'm going to bring it up a little bit just to not lose where that paw goes. And right, so that's the dark section, then there's another bit, and then there's another dark bit there. I'll just start adding that in too. Again, here the first drops kind of like go up from the paw, but they also go this way. I'm just going to add a few more strokes with the nougat just to blend it all together, make it look nice and soft. And now I'm going to use dark sepia and just make it more clear where these different markings are. Tidy that up a little bit. Oops. Needs a little sharpen, I think. This is where it gets really like, no idea which bit's which. Just pay like really close attention to the reference picture. Like take two looks at the picture and then take one look at your work. It's always the best way. And it gets to a bit like this where it's like, what on earth is going on? go. It's all starting to make a bit more sense to me now. At the end, draw around it a tiny bit. I'm going to start on this bit now. So I'm just going to erase and use ivory. So it like goes up to here. So I'm just going to add this in. Oh my gosh, making a right mess. And I'm going to use nougat, the usual, and the fur goes sort of like in this direction. So carrying on from here, I'm just gonna draw under that whisker, and it ends about here actually. There we go, and I'll carry on just mapping in those hair strokes, bringing it down from that top marking, just so it all blends together, going back and forth. And I'm just going to use a bit of dark sepia, like I did with this bit, just to clearly define this dark a bit. To blend it in a little bit. Just gonna slightly underline that whisker. Darken it up a little bit, like just pressing on a bit harder. Then it's sort of like, it's like a little lighter bit here, and it goes a bit darker around there. Leaving some little gaps for some lighter hairs. Just going under that whisker. I'm going to add a bit more nougat, just add a bit more brown. Concentrating it to like the edge of each marking and like bringing it up here and bringing it down here. need a bit of raw umber. I always need a bit of raw umber. I'm just going to add it for a bit of warmth. I'm going to need a lot more around here actually. Yeah, need a lot more around here. I think I'm just going to use a bit of dark sepia and darken this bit up. Just kind of like spot little areas that need to be darker. Just like sort of sit back and look at it as a whole. You can just pick out little bits that need a bit more attention. And like this bit here. This bit. Wow, it's gone really bright outside. You might be able to see it on the video that it's gone way brighter, but oh my gosh, that's like the brightest I've seen it all week. Yeah, I'm just gradually just building up all these darker bits till I'm at a point where I'm happy. No specific area, just wherever I can see it needs it. I think these bits need. I'm gonna add a bit of black just to like heat a little bit to this area. I think this evening I might go to Hobbycraft and get some Crayolas for a video idea that I've had. I'm gonna have an experiment and see what I can do with a cheap pack of pencils. So watch this space, you might see that video. Or if it goes terribly wrong, you might not. Or I might just upload it either way and sort of like talk about why it didn't work or how well it worked. So yeah, I think I will do it either way, to be honest. I think it'd be interesting. I think what I'm gonna do is use my usual paper, because paper makes such a difference, and just try the cheaper pencils on it. See how it goes. I'm quite excited to try that. And I always love a trip to Hobbycraft, so any excuse. I think sometimes it's easy to forget, like, just how much of the work these types of pencils do for you. Because they're so good. So I might realise that I can't do anything with cheaper pencils. But we'll see. I think it'd be good to try it because obviously polychromos are really expensive in the grand scheme of like pencils, and I know not everyone will be able to like splash out on a full set, and even the individuals are quite expensive, and to be able to like do a full tutorial like this you need quite a lot of colours, so it'd be interesting to see what you can do with some cheaper pencils. I'm going to use some dark sepia again now. Actually, I think I might try a bit of burnt umber just to add a bit more of a deeper, richer brown. Just you can see it a little bit through some of these sections. Just a little bit. Right, back to dark sepia now. I feel like this bit is looking a bit weird. I might just use my Tombow eraser. Just try and pick out a few little hair strokes. It might not work, but just going in a few different directions. I always find it looks a bit odd when I try and pick out fur strokes after I've already put the colour down. Like it's not quite strong enough, but I'm going to use dark sepia and just sort of like draw around them a bit to define them more. Just cause I think it'll be looking a bit straight, a bit like flat looking. Needs a bit more interest. That's a little bit better. That might be completely wrong, it might look just the same, but we'll go with that. Just gonna blend some more dark sepia down into this section. Is looking a bit flat. And I'm just gonna carry on with this bit with nougat. And I'm just gonna add some fur strokes in. Of dark sepia, just some extra texture. Right, this is looking a bit weird. I need to... just draw around that whisker a bit. This one needs to go a lot thinner at the end. Happy with how that's looking now. I think I might tidy the whiskers up a little bit at the end, but for now I think that's looking really good. So yeah, once again I hope that you really enjoyed this tutorial. Thank you for sticking with me, and please give this video a like if you've enjoyed it, and subscribe to see more. And next time I think we'll start on the paw. I think that'll be really fun. I think that'll be one of my favourite bits to do, actually. So yeah, stick around and I'll see you next time.